Hello and welcome to Glory Be, interesting people and how they pray.
Each week we chat with interesting people about their lives, their work, and how they pray. I'm Sharon Hanisch.
And I'm Mike Malcolm. Today's guests, very special guests all the way from the second grade at the School of St. Mary, we have John and Millie. Hi, guys.
Hi.
So you guys are scholars. You know a lot of stuff because you have the legendary Mrs. Bloomfield as your teacher. Is she a hard teacher?
Sometimes.
What's the hardest that she is?
She gives us a lot of work.
Yeah?
Yeah. And the best thing is we get brag tags.
And we also get hot chocolate and special things.
Today.
Today? Yeah. Why today?
Because it's the last day. Yeah,
and because we took more than... We were supposed to get 100 in AR test points, but we didn't get enough. So she said at least 75 would be good. But then we came up just like having 73 points, and like that's easy.
Now
we only needed two more.
So now we have 74.
AR points you get from reading a certain amount of books?
Yes, and then you use an iPad and you take a test on them.
Uh-huh.
And how many you get correct, you get more points. And then when you get to 75, you get hot chocolate.
That's so awesome. I love Mrs. Bloomfield.
But it's not like you have to get 75. It's like the whole class together has to get it.
That's great. Okay, so... It's almost like we're in Advent, right? Mm-hmm. Is there anything special? I know Mr. Malcolm was saying yesterday you all had your Christmas program.
Yes.
And then do you have anything special? Is this the last day of school before your Christmas break?
Yes.
Great. So what?
But I wish it wasn't because tomorrow I'd be helper.
So we each day we get every
person in the class is a different. Well, every day, a person gets to be the helper, and
you go in number order.
Yeah,
we have 22 people.
Okay.
So, Millie, will you be able to be helper maybe the first day that you come back?
Yes. Yeah,
I think so.
Oh, good.
Then we'll start
January 1st. Happy New Year.
January 1st. Happy New Year. Okay, so do you get to have a Christmas like party in the class?
We already did that.
We already did that yesterday.
It was very fun, actually.
Awesome.
We had a cookie, a fruit juice punch, and we had a cupcake, and we had
chips.
The Cheetos, and we also
got a color. Yeah.
We got a ring.
Yeah, and we had this Christmas tree that we could build. One end had
a star.
Yeah, one end had a star, and there was a line through the bottom, and the other one had a line through the top, and we would just place them together, and it would make a tree.
Oh, nice. Nice, that's cool.
And we also had this ornament we could color.
Yeah.
We both got mangers.
Did you get to take them home?
Yes.
Yeah. Are they on your trees?
We have to put a string through them.
Yeah. I don't really know where to put the string, though.
Well, in your family, you put the trees up in early December?
Yeah, I put mine up in early December. It depends. Yeah, it depends how busy we are.
Yeah.
Last year we were kind of late, so we kind of got ours right on time this year.
Okay.
My mom was thinking of having two, but we ended up having one.
Yeah. Do you like the big trees?
Yeah, I like the big fake trees, not the real ones.
Why is that?
Because I don't really know. I just get fake trees.
Okay.
We get real trees, but this year's one, it's not that it's really tall, but it also doesn't have a lot of branches. We couldn't fit all our ornaments on.
Mine's broken, so... But you can still hang stuff on it. Yeah. You know how the branches are just connected?
Yeah.
Mine broke, so it kept falling down when you put it up. So, we had to get a new star.
Yeah.
For the tree. Because our star was too heavy for the branches to hold, and it kept just leaning.
Okay.
Do you have any other Christmas decorations at your house?
Uh-huh. We picked lights this year. We haven't done that for the past 8 years. So this year we really wanted to do it.
lights?
We were thinking of wrapping some lights around the tree next to Ramona's room, but we figured out that would keep her up. But we did do something new where we took all the rainbow lights on the house, but then we took some of the white lights in the bushes.
Nice. Yeah, that's what we did last year, so we just did white lights in the bushes, and this year we're just doing it on the house.
And do you have any, like, baby Jesus and cows in the manger?
Yeah, we have that set up.
We have a nativity, too.
Nice.
It's really cool.
I love that. Now, is the baby Jesus in the manger, or do you wait?
We wait until
Christmas.
Yeah. That's when you put him in.
That's what we do, too, yeah.
Do you get to set up who sits where? Like, if the cows are in the back?
They just get to pick where we put it.
Us too.
Yeah. And some people, I know, you know when the three kings go to visit Jesus?
Yeah.
Some people have the three kings outside.
Yeah, somewhere else.
Uh-huh. Do you do that?
We did that. It's just we've been so busy of basketball and stuff. We don't have time to move them closer and closer every day. But we're probably going to move it very close because we really need to do that.
Okay. Well, and do you guys have big plans for your Christmas break?
I actually don't know.
Mm-hmm. What my family's going to do is we have this achondroplasia Christmas thing tomorrow. And there's
what is that?
It's a thing where there's a game of laser tag.
Ooh, I want to go to that.
And also there's a trampoline.
I want to go to that.
And also, you get to play this game where you have a Christmas tree up there, and then everybody brings a gift and places it under the tree, and then you get a number, and then once your number is called, you can go over and pick a present. But you can either pick out a present, or you can go and take one from another kid, but grown-ups can't take the ones from kids.
That's
fair.
That's fair.
That's fair, yeah.
Yeah. Are you going to stay in Tulsa?
My brother took a PJ Masks one from a grown-up.
Oh.
And I took Hatchimals from Will. He's a boy. Why would he want those?
I'm probably guessing he just wants them to get away.
There's also a, you know, I didn't try to take that bow and arrow that stick to the wall.
Yeah, like, you know those, like, suction cup arrows?
Yeah,
those. That stick to the windows?
Mm-hmm.
So tell me, you guys, are each of you, you're not related to each other, but you are related to a priest or a deacon.
Yes.
You've got a priest in the family. You've got a deacon in the family. Who is the priest in your family, John?
My uncle, Father John.
So are you named after him?
I don't know. They just came up with that name.
Maybe also, he's named after you.
We were Uncle Father John is way bigger than me.
Oh, okay.
We were joking yesterday of how John was named after Long John the Donut.
Yeah.
Oh. Do you eat those?
Yes, but
my brother's a hit on chocolate ones.
Ah. Yeah. Now, Millie, you've got a deacon in your family, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who is he?
To me, he's Pops, but his original name from me is Lolly Lolly Lollipop.
Okay. What does the rest of the world know him as?
His real
Tim
name.
Tim Deacon.
Or Deacon Tim?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. It usually goes Deacon before the name.
Uh-huh.
I don't know about that.
So,
like Deacon Bender.
Do you know who baptized you? Did Father John or Deacon Tim baptize
Deacon
you?
Tim.
Or Pops?
I got Lolly Lolly Lollipop did.
I got baptized by my Uncle Father John.
Oh, nice.
And I got baptized by Lolly Lolly Lollipop.
But you don't remember that one, right? Because you guys were little.
Actually, I kind of do.
Yeah?
Because my mom and dad took pictures, so that's what gives me the memory of it.
Right.
Nice.
So that was the first sacrament that you received.
Yes.
And then fall, just a few weeks ago, you received another sacrament.
I didn't.
You did not.
Because, what was that sacrament, though?
I mean, we did reconciliation. Is that it?
Yeah, it's a sacrament.
Yeah.
We didn't.
But I didn't get to do it in fall.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I had COVID.
Yeah. Do you get to do it later?
I did it a couple days ago this week, right?
Oh, yeah. Great.
Oh, and also, We have yearbooks that kind of...
Yeah.
We have yearbooks of the kids.
Yeah.
And I have a picture of my baby sister screaming when she was born.
Oh, sometimes that happens.
She was like, yeah. And she was like pink.
So, John, you received reconciliation just a couple days ago.
Yes.
Like, were you nervous? How did that go?
I was nervous, but in the end, I felt pretty good.
How did you figure out what you wanted to tell the priest when you went in?
I actually don't know. I just said what I needed to say, and then I was gone.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. How about you, Millie? Now, so you received with the whole group.
Yeah.
Now, how did
I did too.
I mentioned pushing my sister off the gymnastics bar. She's
That's
four.
A good one. Yes. Yeah. That's awesome.
Did you have to memorize any prayers?
We said, "Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. This is my first reconciliation."
Yeah.
But for
first
Millie, she said,
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. It has been about a month since the first reconciliation. You didn't need to say that.
Sorry. And then, whoops. And then, were there any other prayers that you had to memorize? An act of contrition?
Yeah, we did that.
We did that as a group.
Ah.
And once we got done, eighth grade went after us. And yeah.
We were Father way better than them.
Yeah, oh, they sure. said the act. He said, "Please say the act of contrition out loud." They were like, But it wasn't then. It was the act of a contrition. You might want to put your
Yeah. So that is the sacrament that you received in the fall, just now. And then you're going to receive another sacrament in the spring.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's that sacrament going to be?
First communion.
First communion.
And so what is that?
It's...
Yeah, for those who don't know, you can just go.
You just walk down the line with your hands folded, and then you receive the Eucharist for the first time. Then you step over and then make a sign of your cross,
Some people before their turn they bow, or when they get there they bow and then say.
Okay.
Something.
And for those who don't know, what is the Eucharist, John? Or Millie?
The bread of Christ.
Okay.
Or the body of Christ.
The body of Christ. What's the difference?
Well, they're kind of
the same, but they bless it to be the body of Christ, but it's not really the body of Christ.
Oh, it's not?
No.
I thought it was.
They just bless
they
it.
They bless it to be.
But it really is, actually.
Yeah.
Once once they bless it, then it does really.
Yes.
But you also, my cousin said it tastes like paper.
Yeah, it doesn't taste like anything special.
Yeah.
But it is.
They're not doing wine this year, so I think maybe they'll just do it for us this
COVID.
Year. But probably
we can't have wine until we're 18, John.
Well, we can have the blood of Christ, though,
yeah.
And it'll be the blood of Christ.
I prefer apple juice as our wine.
Yeah, we did this thing in fish class where we
ate some bread and drank some apple juice.
Yeah. Oh, right, there's that Last Supper reenactment.
Mm-hmm.
So, and so that's what Mass and the Eucharist is all based on, right?
Mm-hmm.
So do you think that Father John is going to come and say your First Communion Mass?
Actually, we might go to his church, but he switched his church.
Ah.
So I think his first one was one downtown.
Okay.
I think.
Holy Family?
Yeah. And then he went to this church. He has his own area. His house is there, and I don't think anybody, it's just his property.
Oh, very nice.
And he has a gate and everything, and he has a gym, and he has a church, and he has a playground.
Tag me there!
It's actually a school, too.
Yeah.
So that's what I think is the playground used for in the gym.
Oh,
but the Mass is for Uncle Father John.
Okay. And then will Deacon Pops come and give you your First Communion?
Probably, because he did for my cousin Elena, who...
Yeah, we usually go to the people that are related to us.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's nice that you have them in the family.
Yes.
So then, looking ahead for sacraments, what's next after First Communion?
Oh.
What do you say, Millie?
Confirmation?
Very good. Yeah, you'll probably do that when you're
High
a teenager.
Five. You got that correct.
And then, John, what's after that?
I have no idea.
Well, some people would say that you could consider becoming a priest yourself, or you could get married.
Actually, when I did this poster in first grade, I said I wanted to become a famous basketball priest.
Oh, there you go.
And I have no idea how I'm going to do
and
that.
And yesterday, he said, vote me for president.
Oh, okay.
I'm running for president.
Yeah, I'll and vote for you, John.
And I was like, I'm voting for you.
Okay, so I have a quick question. What? So our podcast is called Glory Be, Interesting People and How They Pray. Do you all have anything you do with your families, like a fun, do you pray at meals? Do you say your night prayers together?
We do a couple prayers. To add to my prayer, I usually say a couple other prayers. I say like an act of contrition and a glory be and some other prayers. And we say a Hail Mary at the beginning of, before we do our prayers.
You pray. I'm a prayer nerd too. Yeah. Yes. How about you, Millie? Do you guys?
What's
pray?
Your favorite?
Well, my favorite is probably when we go to Thanksgiving. I have kind of this menu. It's not really a menu. It has like this Thanksgiving prayer that I have on it.
Oh, nice.
But also, I think on break I'm gonna have. There's this family thing that we do, and it's like a copy of the
we will play with the buttons, but keep on going.
It's like we have a play of the day Jesus was born. Mm-hmm. But now he had to be a wise man, and I wanted to be a shepherd.
Oh,
and by the way, I'm going to be married next year.
So is this for your family, like all the Elena's grandkids, or?
Yeah, for the grandkids.
So nice. In frog class and for the preschool, we did this thing, and it was like.
My brother was a shepherd, and now I'm so jealous.
I was Joseph.
You were Joseph? That's fun.
What?
I got to be Joseph.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I've never been like one of the persons.
I had to be an angel.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool.
And this girl named Monica, she went. I don't know what school she goes to.
Holy Family.
Okay, she goes to Holy Family now. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's where my uncle Father John used to do mass. So Monica was Mary, and we just had a baby doll as Jesus.
Yeah. Did you have to carry it?
No, Mary did. Yeah.
Did you have to ride on a donkey?
No, Mary did.
Yeah. So you just walked and protected her, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, one of the questions that we ask everybody who's on this podcast is if you could ask the whole world to join you for a single thing that you want to pray for, what would you ask them to join you in prayer for?
That's a really good question.
It's a very good question.
A hard one.
Yes, it's
a hard one. There's a lot of prayers that I would want to say, but I'm trying to think of one. I would like to pray for my special dog Annie because we call him our judge and boss. Mm-hmm. I don't know why we call our grandpa Boss, but his name is Judge and Boss. They used to have three dogs. One of them was named the youngest one was named Bailey.
Yeah.
The second oldest one was named Pig.
Okay.
And the third oldest that I wanted to pray for is Annie, and she died a couple. I think maybe a year and a couple months ago.
And if I could do anything, I would want to pray for my great grandfather's wife.
Mm-hmm.
She died a long time ago, and now my grandfather is still alive. He is 98.
Wow.
Yes.
Well, let's two pray years for until all he's 100. Those people. Would you guys pray with us as we close?
Okay, sure.
Sure. So we usually pray the Glory Be prayer. Do you know that prayer?
Yeah. Yes. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
So we're going to close, and Millie, would you press that button for me? Glory Be is a production of the Office of Communications at the Church of St. Mary in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I'm your producer, Mike Malcolm. See you next time.
Thank you.
And John,
you all.
Will you press this?
You did a great job.
Just a minute. And go.